So this is the Wicked Edge Go. Well, the case isn't. The case is one I found and modified to fit, but in here is the Wicked Edge Go or the Wicked Edge 50. They make different models. The 50 is their basic one. They make a 100, a 120, a 130, and then they make some field models and some really uber flash models. But this is their basic model. So saying, well, it's basic, there's nothing wrong with it at all. It's designed to be slightly portable, so it comes with this nice case that you can wrap everything up in and take it with you. The guts of the machine is this here. And this here can either be clamped onto a bench or something like that, or screwed down into a desk, or as I've done, you can just put three holes in something, put some screws through it, and screw it down. Before you do that though, it's a good idea to disassemble it. Allen key, paddle one, paddle two, and then it also has these arms. Now it's an American system, and it's very, very good. Also very, very expensive, and it does have some issues, and mainly that's that the stones it uses are proprietary, so you have to buy them from them. So saying, you can buy blank paddles, and there's at least one company I know that buys the blank paddles and then adds different sorts of stones to them, Chaucera or Shipton stones, something like that anyway, but again, even doing that is super expensive, or doing that is super expensive. They do sell a variety of stones though. The grip wise, they have a good range. There's 50 and 80, 100 and 200, 400 and 600, 800 and 1000, and then a few oddballs. Now this one comes with a 200 and a 400. Now, a lot of people gripe about the stones because they are griping about the fact that you have to buy two of them, which of course doubles the cost. But why you buy two is because you use both of them at once while the knife is centered in the center. So that means that you need two stones. It also means that your stones last twice as long. So, you know, there's good bits and there's bad bits. Now, the advantage of some of the other models that has a better clamping system. This system, you have to clamp by using the Allen key. And the 130 model, you don't need the Allen key, it clamps just by hand clamp. So knife goes in there, clamp, locks it tight. Better than this method, because this method, first you have to use an Allen key to adjust it and get it just right. Second is that this method ever so slightly kinks the knife in these jaws slightly off to the side, so you need to accommodate that when you're putting everything together. Now, the way you accommodate that is by adjusting these arms up and down, so that lets you choose what angle you want to sharpen at. It's got markings on there to tell you what you're at. But I totally ignore those because I found that they're off a little bit. Instead, what I use is this digital device here. So what I use is this digital device here. It's magnetic. You put the paddle on, drop it in, clamp it on the side. Then you same and set it up at 20 degrees. If they're not 20 degrees, turn that, move to where they are, tighten it back up, put away life. This thing here, brilliant. If you're doing any kind of jumping on a fixed system, something like this, worth waiting on. In the box as well as the paddles, I've got a few other things. It comes with this set of stones, but this set of stones isn't very comprehensive, so I've also bought 800 and 1,000 ones, 1,500, and then diamond films that go all the way up to 50,000 grit. As well as that, I've got something for doing scissors, some longer arms for doing really long knives, a high angle thing for doing really small knives or really steep angles, a few other bits and pieces. If I was going again, would I buy the system? I'd buy the system, but I'd probably buy the 130s. I think the clamp is probably better than this one, but this is a really good system. And what makes it so good, of course, is the fact that now that that's set at 20 degrees, it's locked into 20 degrees, right? It won't do 18, it won't do 25 or something. Every stroke is going to be 20 degrees. Now what you do is you work away just on one side until you've created a burr. Once you've created a burr, you knock the burr off and then you create a burr on the other side, and then you switch to a quieter grit and you go like that. You can also work on a specific spot if you're having an issue or you're taking out a nick or something. You can kind of work backwards for a few strokes if you think that's going to get the knife edge better. You just need to watch when you come off that you don't flick around and round the edge off. The idea is that you push away and up for most strokes. But again, if you think it's going to work better, you can go down. I mean, it's not a great deal of difference. So I'm going to work this away on a 200 grits, then I will put the 600s on, then the 8s, then the 1,000s. Normally, as I say, I'll take a knife up to 50,000, strop it, that gives me a wonderful edge. With this, I'll stop at 1,000 because the Tormex at 1,000 and my Tisprof is at 1,000 at the moment. So I'm just going to stop at 1,000. But wicked edge. Expensive. Stones are a bit annoying because it's all sort of proprietary stuff, and you've got to buy two. On the other hand, they're double-sided and they last twice as long as a single stone would. And to be fair, the stones are really good. I mean, this is what changed my sharpening from being okay with scratches on the blade to being fantastic, polished edges, no scratches, just mint blades, mint edges. Just takes a little bit of work and it's worth it. This is the basic set. The higher up in sets you go, the price gets really expensive. The 100 is basically the same. The 120 has some micro adjusters in here, and then the 130, sorry, the micro adjusters are actually in the arm. The 130 has the clamp and the micro adjusters, and then upwards from there, there's the professional series, and they're stupid amount of money, but fantastic, fantastic machines. Wicked Edge Go, I'd rate it. But we'll see how it compares to the other four systems when we do the test.